The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the priestly division of Abinadab, and his wife was from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Both were righteous in the eyes of God, observing all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blamelessly. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Once he was serving as priest in the division, turned before God. According to the practice of the priestly service, he was chosen by lot to enter the sanctuary of the Lord to burn incense. Then, when the whole assembly of the people was praying outside, at the hour of the incense offering, the angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right of the altar of incense. Zechariah was troubled by what he saw, and fear came upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, because your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear a son, and you shall name him John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He will drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit from his mother's womb, and he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. He will go before him in the spirit and the power of Elijah to turn the hearts of fathers towards children and the disobedient to the understanding of the righteous, to prepare a people fit for the Lord." Then Zechariah said to the angel, "How can this be? For I am an old man, and my wife is advanced in years." The angel said to him in reply, "I am Gabriel, who stand before God. I was sent to speak to you and announce to you the good news. But now you will be speechless, and I am unable to speak until the day these things take place, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their proper time." Meanwhile, the people were awaiting for Zechariah and were amazed that he stayed for a long time in the sanctuary. And when he came out, he was unable to speak to them. And they realized that he had seen a vision in the sanctuary. He was gesturing to them, but remained mute. Then, when his days of ministry were completed, he went home. After this time, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and she went into seclusion for 5 months, saying, "So has the Lord done for me at a time when he has seen it fit to take away my disgrace before others." My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
The Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening, all. There's a book I chance to read through. It's a book titled "Why Not?" But the very title of the book made me curious, and it was something about the possibilities of imagination, creativity, and going beyond what we see. I remember when Pope Francis came to the Philippines, he was confronted by a very difficult situation when he was asked by a child, sa UST, wala sa script. He was asked by Giselle Palomar, a young poor girl in the UST community. Tinanong po si Pope Francis, ang hirap na tanong, sabi niya, "Why God allows children to suffer?" Siguro, the youngers talking about the suffering of the young children, begging. Children who are not educated, children who are abused by different ways of our society, were not given their right to be educated or to grow normally. Parang natural lang si Pope Francis. Mayroon siyang speech na prepared. Mayroon siyang entourage, magagaling na theologian. Parang sa tanong na to, bakit nahihirapan, pinapabayaan, mahirapan ng Diyos ang mga bata? You know, ang sagot ni Pope Francis, ito, there are questions too difficult that we do not have yet the answers. Masala. There are questions that are too difficult that we do not yet have the answers. May mga tanong na napakahirap sagutin. Wala pa tayong sagot ngayon. Parang it was a humbling answer for St. Pope Francis. Parang tatanong ko rin, kailan kaya magkakaroon ng anak? Itong si Elizabeth at si Karaya, patanda na sila. Parang marami siguro sagot. There are no immediate answer in our questions. So, ang tanong natin, kayo may ask you, do you have prayers that are not yet answered? Meron ba kayong mga panalangin na antagal-tagal nyo nang pinapanalangin, wala pang sagot? There are questions, there are prayers, they are too difficult that we do not have the answers yet. Actually, kahapon niya ako, 2 days ago, meron akong karanasan na just want to share with you. Mga more than a year, meron po akong business na bahay. Napakaganda ng bahay. Ganda ng bahay. Malaki yung bahay, maraming kwarto. Business ko. Pagkatapos ng blessing, siyempre, bibless ko yung pamilya. Nasaan po yung pamilya? Lumapit sa akin yung mag-asawa. Sabi ko sa mag-asawa, medyo may edad na sila. Nasaan po yung anak ninyo? Father, wala po kami anak. Ang laki ng bahay. Wala kami anak. Sabi, wala pa po. Ilang years na kayong kasal? 10 years. 10 years na silang mag-asawa. Wala pang baby. And sabi ko, I pray for you. Sana may magmamana ng bahay na to. Yung lalaki, he works so hard sa government. Yung babae, she runs a very good business. Both of them works hard. Pero like Elizabeth and Sikaraya, para saan? After that one, I also pray for them. You know, 2 days ago, bininyagan ko yung baby nila. Ang saya-saya nila, after 11 years na kami sila ng baby, ginawa pa akong ninong kahit hindi ako pwede. Ang dami-dami ng ninong at ninang, pero sa totoo, sabi mo, siguro kaya maraming ninong at ninang because they are so happy and we are so happy for them. After many years when our prayers are not answered, we are like Sikaraya. We begin to doubt. Sikaraya is leading the prayer. Sikaraya is there inside the sanctuary, leading the prayer of the community. Pero siya mismo hindi na naniniwala yung panalangin niya ay masasagot. Or there will be an answer beyond their own expectations. Pag sumagot kasi ang Diyos, 2 beses sa gospel, in its proper time, and when the Lord finds it proper. I believe in the potential. I believe in the possibilities. I believe in the power of the potent. What is possible? Kasi kung minsan nakikita lang natin yung ngayon, you are so limited. Kung nakikita mo lang yung ngayon, matandang mag-asawa, wala na. O kaya, Mary and Joseph, batang-bata, iiwanan na itong lalaki, wala na. Di-divorce na ni Joseph si Mary, wala na. Or itong matanda, they're advanced years, sabi nga ni Sikaraya sa mismo, wala nang chance. No, wala nang buhay after us. I believe in the potential. I strongly believe for possibilities. Kung bisa kasi, nakakalimit yung mga painful experiences of failures and limitations. Alam niyo po, mayroong isang school sa Chicago. Pag nag-exam ka, hindi mo nakuha yung exam, hindi ka lalagyan ng failure o fail. Ang lalagay na grade sa'yo, hindi zero, o kaya bagsak, hindi. Ang lalagay sa'yo grade, kung bata pa ako, so mag-aral dito. Ang lalagay na grade sa'yo, not yet. Kunyari, nag-exam ka, hindi ka pumasa. Hindi lalagyan ng failure o fail, hindi. Ang lalagay, not yet. Para sinasabi ng school system na yun, at sa mga bata, sana yun hindi pa niya nakuha. Darating ang panahon, makukuha niya rin yan. Do you see that school? It talks about the potential of the child. Not now, not yet. Not, hindi mo na, pero makukuha niya rin yan. Huwag po kayo masyadong magalit. When things are not yet perfect, God is not yet finished with us also. We are working towards it. And don't be impatient. Kailangan natin ang determination. Other than creativity, it is the determination to see beyond. Ako, bilib ako sa mga, di ba po, yung eagle, it's always used as a symbol of nations, of freedom, of strength, of leadership. And we have all the reasons why. Alam niyo po yung mga ibon? Yung mga ibon. Pag umulan, yung mga ibon, they take shelter dito sa loob ng simbahan. Dati yung mga ano natin, sa Dilya, ginagawa ang salilong ng mga shelter ng mga ibon. Pag umulan, punta sila sa mga bahay, sa mga kisame, sa mga halaman. Pero ano po, hindi nagtatago yung mga ibon. Pag umulan, nagtatago sa ulan. Nagtatago. Pero yung mga eagle, pag umulan, they do not hide. They keep on flying. But they fly above the clouds to avoid the rain. Nakita niyo ginagawa nila. How about us? Pag may problema, nagtatago ba tayo? Pamukha ng mga maliliit na ibon. I hope we have that spirit to go beyond. That determination to go above the clouds. Because we are capable and you have it. The potential is there. Ako, ayaw kong kausap yung mga tao negative. Yung pagkausap mo, problema. Yung parang pagkausap mo, parang ang laki-laki ng problema. Gusto kong kausap yung, they look for the solution. They look for the answers. They look for the possibilities, the potentials, the creatives, the imaginative, the artists. I like to talk to them. I like to listen to them. Hindi yung parating detrimental. Ganyan na lang. Wala nang mangyayari. Ganyan lang tayo na. I think with the kind of life we have lang na dito sa Pilipinas, we need a lot of creativity, determination, imagination, and capacity to go beyond the situation. Not below, but above. Meron pong movie. Actually, it's a book which we enjoyed during our seminary years. Ang title po ng book, Little Prince. Yung Little Prince, it was shown few weeks ago. Kung gusto nyo panoorin nyo po, matadownload pa naman yata sa internet. More than the book, meron na siyang sequel, meron na siyang application in the modern time. Pero ano siya, comic na parang na hindi po siya yung ano siya yung it is a beautiful movie from the book. At yung pinaka kilalang quotation from that book is also related with our reflection. Sabi po ng Little Prince, can you read it with me? Kung nababasa po niya, sabi niya, here is my secret. It is very simple. It is only through the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the naked eye. Hindi nakikita ng mata ang mas mahalaga dahil ang puso lamang ang nakakita kung ano ang pinakamahalaga. Do not be enslaved by what you see. Batang payat, batang maingay, batang malikot sa simbahan. Ang isang batang patikas yung ulo. But when you see from the heart of the potential of this child, you could see that there is something more beyond what the eyes can be. Always keep that. Use your heart to see your imagination and your faith that there's something beautiful that will happen before us. Kawawa si Zacarias. He already gave up. May panalangin siya. Siya mismo pala, kahit na nanalangin siya, sa katagalan ng panalangin niya, siya mismo hindi na naniniwala sa sagot sa kanyang panalangin. Pwede pala yun, no? Yung you are praying and then you yourself do not really believe that your prayer will be answered. That's when the angel came. Sabi niya, is that possible? I'm already old and my wife is already advanced in years. Siya mismo, nananalangin siya, pero nagdududa. Let this be our inspiration for this evening's Mass. Actually, yung title ng ating reflection, yung Why Not, is actually from Robert Kennedy. Sabi ni Robert Kennedy, some men see things as they are and ask, why? Bakit? But I dream of things that never were and ask, why not? Isn't it? Kung misan yung mga tao, may problema, bakit? Bakit? Bakit tinulubog? Bakit may bagyo? Bakit may traffic? Bakit mahirap yung buhay? Bakit ganyan ang ugali ng aking kamag-anak? Why? Bakit? Why? Delilah? Friends, baby. Why do you ask why? Sabi niya, but me, I have seen things that never were. And say, and ask, why not? Why not? The potential, the possibilities of things that will happen beyond the capacity to imagine it, our own imagination. With God, nothing is impossible. With your faith, I hope you don't give up on your prayer. Let hope be the inspiration of this Mass and our Simbangari. Hold on to your prayers. Keep them in your pocket, in your heart. And I believe in due time, in God's time, He will be there to surprise us more than our own expectation. I just want to end with a book I read when I was a seminary. Ang title po ng libro, All I Really Need to Know, I Learned in Kindergarten. Ako rin maganda sa libro nito, kay Robert Fulton. Si Robert Fulton, ano po siya, Protestant pastor. Pero yung books niya, marami po yan, marami books niya. Maganda lang, magandang basahin. Very entertaining, and then maikli, and very meaningful. Meron siyang tinatawag na Robert Fulton Creed na tawag po. Parang Creed niya. In all his books, nandun sa introduction. And I want to read it for you. Sabi po ni Robert Fulton, I believe that imagination is stronger than knowledge. That myth is more potent than history. That dreams are more powerful than facts. That hope always triumphs over painful experiences. That laughter is the only cure for grief. And I believe that love is stronger. Can we read it together to close our reflection? The Creed of Robert Fulton together. I believe that imagination is stronger than knowledge. That myth is more powerful than history. That dreams